Hi students, welcome back. Coming to the next topic in the subject, distributed system is message passing interface. So you already know the concept of message passing. A message passing means passing the message from one end to the other end. Either it may be a client to server or server to client. Okay, or in the distributed environment. Now let's see what is this interface, the message passing interface, MPI. So the MPI is a specification designed for parallel application. The main this MPI is used for designing for parallel applications. If you want to transfer the data over the means in the distributed environment, you need to use one type of interfacing so that it can be useful in some parallel applications. The goal of MPI is to provide a widely used standard for writing message passing programs. So these interface attempts to be practical, portable, efficient and flexible. So that's why we are using this message passing interface, which is used to provide widely used standard for writing message passing programs. Okay, so a message passing library specification is what it is going to what are the specifications, the library specifications of this message passing. One is the message passing model and not a compiler specification, not a specific product. So it is just a message passing model, this interface. It means it's type of acting as an interface for between the system and not a compiler specification. So it is not a compiler specification and not a specific product also. Why we are using this MPI? What are the reasons for using the MPI? You get it out. We are using the message passing technology. Then why it needed this interface is needed. So the reasons for using this message passing interface is for standardization, for portability. A portability means you can work in any environment. So there is, if you are installing some system, it can be run in any operating system. So this is a portability is there. Performance opportunities will be there. If you want to increase the performance of your system, you can add some more features to this message passing interface. That is, a performance opportunity will be increased. And mainly the functionality. Over 115 routines are defined in this message passing interface. Okay. And another reason for using this MPI is the availability. So variety of implementations are available in this message passing interface, both in the case of vendor and the public domain. So for these reasons, we are using the message passing interface for standardization, portability, performance opportunities, functionality and the availability. Okay, let me show you the general message passing interface program structure. So how you are going to write the program and what are the steps that are involved in this message passing interface. So the first is the message passing interface include files, means the library functions, that is a hash include files has to be right. You have to include the message passing MPI in the header file. So the first starts the general program with MPI include files. After that, you need to initialize the MPI environment. You means you need to start that. If you want to start using the interfacing, you need to initialize that MPI environment. Not only including the files, you need to initialize. After that, do work and make message passing calls. So whatever the programming concept that you want to be implemented, that program you can write here and make a message passing calls in this environment. Okay, after that, terminate the MPI environment. So whenever you initialize, means don't forget to terminate the MPI environment also, so that there is no wastage of memory. So this is a general program of MPI program structure. MPI include files and you need to initialize the MPI environment. Later you have to do your work and then terminate the MPI environment. Let me show you a simple example. MPI programming, the message passing interface. So what I said, first you need to write the MPI program. After that, you need to compile and link that program and run the MPI programs. Okay, so here is a hello.c. It's a general C program. So you already know how to write the hello.c. Just you need to print hello on the screen. So let me see, use a MPI interface by using the C program. So you can initialize or you can terminate and you can call the MPI interface in any of the language. So that's why I said it is a portable MPI is a portable. So first thing is you need to Initialize means you need to include the header files, include mpi.h. So it provides a basic MPI definition and types that are present in this mpi.h. So without these, the MPI cannot work. So you need to include the library files. So these library files will be used at the time of the linking. Next, stdio.h is for the standard C programs. For printf, scanf, we are using this stdio.h in the C programs. Now write the program. Int main, the argument C and the character argument V. Now, first thing what I said, you need to initialize the arguments, means the MPI has to be initialized with an arguments. MPI initialize, int means initialize. Argument C and argument V. So this here, the initialization starts. This MPI int starts the message passing interface. So after that, you need to print the hello world that in the screen. And after the program, whatever you want to write and whatever the calls that you are performing, after the completion of the program, you need to finalize, means you need to terminate the MPI. So exit the MPI. So the for that MPI finalize function, you need to call so that the MPI can be exit. Finally, return zero. Okay. So this is about the message passing interface. Thank you.